Freeze, woman.
Who are you?
Just give me the money. Take it out of the register and give it to me.
No, I can't do this.
You don't understand. Do it now!
I don't have the key to the register. I'm calling the police.
No, I can't let you do that. Just stick with the plan, and he'll be right as rain in no time.
All right, Miss Cykes. Now that you've completed your paperwork, you can take on this case that I've discovered.
Finally! Ah, your training process is horribly drawn out.
Dial it back, Athena. Do you remember what I said during your interview?
Ah, that's right.
So, would you two like to defend this case all by yourselves?
Absolutely. Wait, you too?
You're probably a little tired of me taking charge here. So, why don't you let Trucy be your assistant?
I haven't known you for that long, boss, but sure. Trucy, would you like to be my assistant?
Oh, sure! I haven't done this in a while.
I'm warning you, though. It's a high-profile case. I've already met the defendant down in the detention center, and he's quite difficult, to say the least.
Well, he can't be any worse than any of Apollo's clients.
Well, Apollo's only taken up a couple cases, and neither were like this. Also, he completed his training with me not that long ago, anyhow.
I'm sure this case can't be that bad.
You sure?
110% positive.
Alright, fine. I feel bad not giving Apollo this chance since he was hired before you, but he's off on his own today. The case files are on my desk. You better get going soon. Your appointment at the detention center's in half an hour.
Alright! You won't regret this. Let's get going, Trucy.
After you!
Seems like we're a bit early. Figured our client would have been here by now.
Maybe they're just running a bit behind?
You ain't gonna touch me, you hear? I'm the real deal, man. Get your filthy hands off of me! What are you two idiots looking at?
Oh my gosh!
Excuse you?
What do you want? What do you coppers need with me now? I ain't afraid to go whack on ya.
Don't think about laying a finger on her. We're with Phoenix Wright.
Phoenix Light? Yo, who's this fella?
It's Phoenix Wright, my daddy.
Well, whoever he is, tell him I don't give a damn. You two go scram.
Well, if you want to treat your defense team like that, my partner and I will gladly take our business elsewhere. Good day, sir.
Hey, wait a minute. Did you say defense team?
Well, I'm supposed to defend you in court. Seeing as I was given the case by Mr. Light.
Oh, why didn't you just say so, my dude? I didn't think my parents would get a lawyer down here so soon. Nice to meet ya. I'm Waki, biggest gangster this side of the city.
I'm impressed by how quickly his mood changed. Does this mean you're gonna cooperate with us, Waki?
Yeah, girl. You have my attention.
Alright then. Let's start with a few questions.
Ask away, lawyer lady.
Let's start with your account of what happened last night.
What happened? What happened? I'll tell you what happened. I did it, man. I put that girl in her place, you dig? She was stepping, man. She got what was coming to her, I can tell you that.
Are you confessing that you assaulted someone?
Yeah, I'm the real deal. I'm the heir to a gangster empire.
So far, everything you've said has led me to believe the exact opposite of the heir to an empire. Well, if you are confessing to the assault, then I guess it's case closed.
Hey, wait! Athena!
Huh? What, Trucy?
I know he's lying. He can't be guilty of the crime! At least, I'm pretty sure he isn't.
This is not the time to be doing baseless guesswork. That's what Boss would tell me.
You two are so silly.
Athena, I can just tell.
I said this isn't the time to be doing—
I have this power. It lets me concentrate and perceive things about people.
Don't be silly, Trucy. You're starting to make me angry.
I'm serious, Athena. I saw that he twitched when he said I'm the real deal. I think that should tell us something.
Huh. Good eye, girl.
Don't believe me? See for yourself, dog. Go to the Borscht Bowl Club and have a look around. You'll see my mark all over that dump.
The Borscht Bowl Club?
Did I stutter? Man, I swear, do all you pretty girls have nothing going on upstairs?
I'm gonna pretend I didn't hear that. For Trucy's sake.
Maybe we should get going. I don't want to see you get angry again.
I think you're right. You have a good day, Waki. We'll do our best to help you.
You sure you're all done with me? I can answer questions, I promise.
Nine, forget my other questions. We'd be better off investigating the scene. All right, the crime scene. A place where I can get in the zone, focus, and get away from all the needless—
Halt! Hey, you two! Who do you think you are, just waltzing into a crime scene like that?
Today, Junior!
We're the defense team for Waki, and we're here to investigate. And hopefully have someone with less attitude standing before us. Apollo would probably say I'm the one with the attitude, but too bad for him.
Oh, well, you could have just opened with that when you barged in.
She's the one who spotted us without saying hello. Might I ask who you are, Ms.?
Oh, yeah, that. The name's Ema Skye, forensic detective.
So, Detective Skye, can you give us a rundown of the crime that occurred here?
As of right now, the police have identified the assailant as the defendant, Waki Kitake, the son of Winfred and Plum Kitake.
Wait, Kitake?
You know them, Trucy?
They're one of the biggest mob families in the world! I didn't make the connection earlier. Oops!
Did you say biggest mob in the world?
Yeah, Top Hat's correct. Not a sleight of hand trick, but I can't say I'm disappointed with her assessment.
Why, thank you.
I'm sensing this forensics chick is biased. So we're essentially defending a known gangster.
You're telling me you didn't research your client before taking the case?
Please don't say what I'm thinking, Widget. This case keeps getting better and better. I love it!
Either way, Waki is being accused of aggravated theft and assault. Sorry, could you do a card trick for me, Top Hat? I'm getting a little bored.
Well, it's best if we stick to the case, right, Detective?
Yeah, I agree. What evidence have you collected that would make you arrive to this conclusion, by the way?
Well, for starters, we have footage of Waki at the restaurant during the day and at night during closing. I discovered that his fingerprints were on the object used to bludgeon the waitress as well.
And what is this object?
It was a pistol.
A pistol?
Yeah, a pistol. Though I wonder why someone would go through the effort to hit someone with it rather than just shoot them. It seems very inconvenient if you ask me, but hey, I'm not the forensic scientist I wanted to be, so what do I know?
But you said you were a forensic detective.
There's a difference, Top Hat.
Just for clarity, you found Mr. Kitake's fingerprints on that pistol.
That we did. It has a signature on the handgun, after all.
Uh-oh.
The Kitake family has a special crest. Every weapon they own has this crest as well as the owner's initials engraved into the grip. Lo and behold, both the crest and his initials are right on the side. It's near impossible to forge this, seeing as no one knows who crafts the guns.
Why can't the police investigate the maker of the guns?
Well, you asking me allows me to use my stupid career as a police detective for good. So thank you for that.
Right. The flames grow ever stronger.
But that information is classified, so unless it becomes relevant to the case, I cannot disclose why.
It's okay. I'm glad I can make you feel a bit better.
No need to suck up when she already has a bias towards your magic. Thank you, Detective. Do you mind if we have a quick look around the place?
Not at all. Just don't break anything, or you'll have to answer to me.
We wouldn't dream of it, Detective Skye!
Jeez, whoever robbed this place sure made quite a mess.
I mean, it is Walkie we're talking about. He seems like the type of guy who'd want to put on a show for the people around him.
Given his intelligence, this isn't out of the ordinary, I bet. Based on this, we know there was a struggle of some sort.
Or maybe the robber pushed through all of this on his way out.
They were likely in a hurry, so that could be the case.
Maybe that's not important for us to find out. Well, anyways, we should go do some investigating, right?
Yep, let's do this. Grape juice? I thought this was a bar.
Yeah, you'd expect something a little more liquor-like? In fact, I can't even remember seeing any alcohol in here.
You've been here before?
Before Apollo came to work for us, Daddy used to come down here and talk to his friends and play cards for fun. And then he'd come home and work on a case or two.
The stories these walls could tell. Huh. What's this? Some sort of graduation cap? And it's missing the tassel, too.
Stop! I would appreciate it if you could unhand my cap at once.
This is your cap? Then what is that on your head?
That is my freshman year spare. A worthy spare, if you must know. Don't you know people must have a spare for everything these days? Because it's better to have and not need than to need and not have. After all, if you need something and you don't have it, then you won't be able to do what you wanted to do with it.
Okay, we get it. Just take the stupid hat.
How dare you insult my cap? A man's cap is nothing to tread lightly on, I'll have you know. A man's cap is like his crown, a king's symbol of prowess and power. I'll have you know I'm a very prestigious member of my Ivy League school, a place where I learned respect, a trait you are clearly lacking.
Okay, jeez. Who the hell are you? Why are you in here? This is a crime scene! You can't just be walking around here!
Me? Oh, well, of course. I am Wesley Stickler, third-year science student at Ivy League University.
That still doesn't answer why you're here.
Oh yes, I am one of the witnesses to that horrid crime. Witnesses are quite important, you see. We are the key to the lock that conceals the truth. Without keys, such as myself, the justice system would never be—
Okay, fine, just please... Please, just tell me a bit of what you saw. Nothing more, nothing less.
Well, I saw many things that night. I saw the beautiful lampshade swaying above my table. I saw my piping hot food ready on my plate to be devoured in all its excellence. I saw my clothes look absolutely dapper in the—
No, I mean, what did you see pertaining to the assault and theft?
Oh, well, I can't tell you that.
All right. Why not?
I swore an oath of silence until the day of the trial.
You can't even tell us a little bit?
Absolutely not. I swore an oath of honesty, an oath of integrity. It was a promise to not only myself, but to the people of this fine town. A pledge of pride and justice, one that must be kept. Do you take me for a traitor? A man who not only betrays the justice system, but puts the safety and sanctity of his town into jeopardy?
Shut up! We'll go look elsewhere.
Very well.
Athena, your face is as red as that pendant is.
Oh, this isn't a pendant, actually. this is Widget.
Oh?
Part of how I continue using psychology after my education is with this little thingy. It helps me see people's emotions.
Whoa! That's really cool!
I'm glad you think so, Trucy. But that aside, we really need to get back to work here. And I need to try to calm down.
Hey, Trucy. Do you know what this piano's doing here?
Well, sometimes they have people come in and play. They even offered a position to Daddy once, but he turned it down.
Why did he decline?
He already had a job, silly! He couldn't devote time to being a lawyer and playing piano.
I didn't even know Boss could play piano.
Oh, trust me, he can't.
Huh?
He doesn't really play the piano so much as he plays with it. If he ever offers to play a song for you, just say yes and pop in some earbuds or something. After that, when he asks what you think, pull them out like nothing happened and then just smile away. Easy.
If it's bad enough to make Trucy block her eardrums, it must be more than abysmal.
Oh, hey, this is kind of cute. Oh, my college never sold anything like that. More grape juice?
It seems like it's their big ticket item.
Not a very big ticket if you ask me, but fair enough. Huh, this one's busted. That's weird.
Why is that weird? Maybe someone just dropped it.
Well, we should see glass shards nearby if that was the case. I don't see any here, which is odd.
Oh, yeah. Then maybe someone cleaned them up?
We might want to hold on to this, just in case. Well, that seems like all there is to see here. Now that we've gotten the annoying people out of our way, we actually did some decent evidence collecting. I feel much better just thinking about that.
Where to next, Athena?
Well, wait a sec, actually.
What is it?
Look, under that bottle.
Huh?
Oh, it's the tassel to that guy's graduation cap. I guess we should go bring it back to him. Miss Skye!
Ah! What? Don't sneak up on me like that!
Sorry. I was just wondering if you could get Mr. Stickler for us? We need to return something of his.
Oh, okay then. Stickler!
Yes? It's you. What do you want?
We found this. Figured you'd want a piece of your crown back.
Where did you find that?
We found this in the piano room, underneath a broken bottle. This dude is acting super weird again. Are you okay?
Well, I... Oh, that's my cue. Class is about to begin. Have to jet. Goodbye.
Wait!
What was that all about?
Weird kid.
Do you know what that was all about?
Listen, kid. I'm an investigator, not a therapist.
I'm kind of ashamed to not know myself. But I guess a degree in psychology doesn't let me read minds.
Speaking of which, you two need to leave. We're about to start wrapping things up here, and we can't have people hanging out while there's no cops around or anything.
Well, then what can we do now?
I suppose we can head back to the office and look over the evidence. I feel like most of today was a disaster.
Oh, chin up. It's not that bad. We can save Vaki yet. You just gotta have faith.
Maybe you're right. Well, let's head on back and get to work.
Well, I'll go grab the case folder and write everything down.
Okay! So, that guy was weird. I mean, all we tried to do was give him his tassel back.
Oh hey, you guys. How's the case going so far?
Just a stubborn defendant, rude detectives, and weird witnesses.
Ah, I know that feeling all too well. Hey, I warned you it'd be difficult.
I'll show you, boss. I can handle this. Right, Trucy?
Oh, right?
Well, Athena, the trial's tomorrow. I wish you both the best of luck.
Don't worry, boss. We can handle this.
I'd help out now, but I'll have to chime in before the trial starts tomorrow. Reason being, well, I'm going out to celebrate.
What?
Huh?
Well, it's been long overdue, but I recently learned of the reappearance of someone important to you, Trucy. I'll explain in due time.
Who is it, Daddy?
I promised I'd celebrate my victory with him from a while back. Ah, Zach Grammery.
That trial from way back?
Mm-hmm. It's finally time to celebrate now that he's resurfaced.
Can I come along? I love the Grammarize!
Sorry, Trucy. No can do.
Okay.
Have a great time, boss.
Thanks, Athena. And good luck once again. I'll see you tomorrow.
Thank you.